Welcome back. WeArEuS, and this... This, my friends, is Curse of the Dead Gods. And, as promised, we've returned with more of the Dead Cells collaboration. I've already chosen the weapon set that we're going to be running. It's basically a dagger, which is pretty normal. But... It allows you to auto-dodge if you're charging an attack. I want to see how that works. It might be garbage. I mean, the pistol already is, but who knows? It might surprise us. I tried last video, after we ended it, I came back and played again. There were bombs on the table waiting for us. I said, you know what? Why not? And so I did. Ooh. And wouldn't you know it? I took them as far as I could go and met the final boss, too. The problem with those bombs, though, is that they have they're two-handed weapons. So they have all of the problems of two-handed weapons. Automatic dodge during a charged attack. Next, since you're too inept to actually attack me directly. Whoop. Here, have this. Never mind. Probably shouldn't get hit by those anyway. Absolutely disappointing weapon. And I still don't know if it actually does, how it's actually supposed to work. Wow. Wow. That's actually not bad. I mean, for a sword. Should I reroll or just... I don't like these. Shield, though. Yeah. Oh, I can't even afford it. Never mind. We're looking to go the distance, so I'm not paying blood for anything. Also, I took the wrong path. I was supposed to go with the money, I somehow ended up here. Oh great, another one of these. Thank you. doesn't really seem worth it. Also, you may notice my kill counter isn't going down. That's because... Oh, that is unfortunate, actually. I don't have any freaking money. This gives the knives a chance to not be absolute garbage, and... Do we take it, though? Actually... I mean, the automatic dodge during a charged attack is garbage, but... if only the charged attack was actually more useful. Wonderful, because it's not like we are already hurting the money as it is. Talking to myself, of course, because I was looking at my greed counter, and that led to me not even noticing I actually need the gold. But I want this. It led to me not even noticing the guy was about to storm attack. Hey there, boys. Shot off in time. Oh, give me something good. Sacrificed it is. Well, it's not really sacrificed, is it? It's being offered. We do need the money in order to pass through the doors. That's something I have to keep in mind. Let's go with money here and then... our other two weapons are trash. Keep in mind, our objective is to actually beat the final boss, which is not very likely given... what weapons we have. I mean, it couldn't hurt work. Well, hold on. What is the... nope. Trying to see its maximum range. Its maximum range is about I'm trying to plan ahead for the final boss, which I might not even reach, but on the off chance I do, I want to make sure that I'm properly equipped to deal with it. I'll get rid of the corruption. Range on the pistol is better for when the final boss is trying to regen his health. Forgot I had the hammer to do stuff like that with. Whoops! This way. Hey there, buddy. Who's going to die alone in there? At least he got to die with some company. Don't get me wrong about the bombs. I like them. They were just really, their effectiveness, it was just too inconsistent. Either the bombs were really good, and that it depended on the movement speed of the enemy that you were using them against. Either they were really good, or they did nothing for you. Well, that's not true. That's not true. It's not like I don't know how to parry, it's just, it's easier not to. But I've got blessings that benefit me if I do. I should not pay for that. Although, this might actually make the, this actually works against itself. God, pistols suck. I mean, you know, this pistol in particular is bad, but I mean, look at this. Plus 30% damage while in the darkness. Cool, I guess? Plus 30% damage against burning enemies. You can only have one of these. Even though you can have them both on the same weapon. Wonderful. see a slight use case for the hammer, but not really. Absolutely terrible. But at least I am being healed in between areas, so there's that, I guess. I haven't picked up anything to make myself stronger. That's a no. Did not expect the third one. I was expecting the trap to activate. A burning enemy. This is what I need. I'm going to have to eat a curse for it. Either way, we get cursed, but this... this is bad. It's between these two. This would help with the healing I get from passing through doors. This gives me control over my healing. And I can't have both. And I also have a relic that gives me increased damage for every 1,000 gold I have. I need as much as I can get since I'm using throwing daggers? I'm probably going to pay for this. Just like that, we come across the curse. The newest curse introduced with the collaboration that gives us the flaming head of the character from Dead Cells. God, I wish I could get a close-up of that. I need to kill more enemies. Oh, good lord, it's the boss. This is actually worst-case scenario. God. that was a very, very poor showing. Please. Chance to inflict poison. You know, I'll take it. The final hit of combo attacks always lands critical anyway. I don't need healing, since we have that in the kit and we do need to take this path filled with money. Although, now that I think about it, I don't need to pay to go through doors anymore, so there's that at least. About the healing on the burning enemies too. Since this weapon doesn't deal guaranteed lightning damage, I can't get that burning effect all the time. Crap. I might have to use the dagger to get me through.
Shadows can play tricks upon the eye. Best they be named so the enemy cannot lie. Regular enemies are concealed while in the shadows. Concealed enemies are revealed by light and when attacking. But you do 20% more damage in darkness.
Well, all of that sucks. Of course I do. Is not that bad. Once I get 5 more kills, we're set. God, that really does nothing for me. There's a path up ahead that lets me buy a new weapon, so maybe I should look into that. Whoops. I do not get the healing from a crit if I crit them and the crit kills them. There's gold that way, but I mean, I really need that healing, though. We'll take it, because why not? Okay, we need to set everything on fire, and then... No longer take 50% more damage. You don't even get to heal off of crits that kill, even though they landed to kill them. Scroll of Sacred Songs gains obtained when offering a gear. Gains obtained when offering a gear object to the gods are increased by 33%. Sure, why not? Consistently dissatisfied by the things that drop anyway. needs healing. Almost. He needs healing, though. Can't have any of that. I only got 3 healing off of that. He wasn't on fire when he died. That's my fault. I was having too much fun stunning him out of his attacks. No, we can't have this. Actual frick. I didn't even fully register that was a trap. I have to say, it really sucks to not be able to get that extra 3 healing. Not beautiful. That was terrible. Now, these here are the bombs. They're actually really good. They're fun. And this one comes with the ability to heal me for each enemy killed. We like that. But I do like the crossbow of the condemned as well. I think I'm getting this. But I probably shouldn't, because, I mean, let's be honest. We can't really afford to lose this amount of gold that gives us 4,000 times 2%. That's so we get 8% more damage. That's pretty terrible. And the healing we get from killing them, does that even stack with the healing from... Let's find out. Relics, please. Well, maybe we should have gone for the gold. The next boss is easy, so we pretty much guaranteed to win. As long as we're careful. See, that's not being careful. Ooh, got lucky. That'll help. Can't even keep my goddamn greed kill counter. Healing more. Stop that, because one of them isn't on fire. Really? Goodness. I did not expect him to take an extra step forward. This is how I handle these. It takes extra time, but I don't get hit. It pays for itself, frankly. Plus 9 dexterity. Yeah, we're taking that. Of course, it sucks to have something that only does one thing. I can't weaken anymore since we don't have the hammer. More damage while in the light. I could reroll these. Plus 66 to all healing effects.
accursed again. I hope it's nothing that affects a boss fight. Great. So now I cannot dodge 5 times, but only 4. That guy's dash was a lot harder to dodge, or I'm thinking of the wrong boss. Well, he's on fire when he dies. I only healed for 16. What is that? Well, that, now that I'm reminded that I have the haste from this curse. Huh. Now this has to go. I need to be able to see enemies sooner. Critical damage. That would help with my healing. It also gives me damage. But I need the health more. If I offer this up, I get 33% more on the corruption reduction, but does it? No, it doesn't go back. What a waste. I was hoping it would take away a curse. Start with money, or I could get ahead on healing, which I wouldn't need if I could stop getting hit. If the bombs inflicted fire more consistently, I could just use them. Barely got.
What? I was outside of that.
Somebody's got to put baby in a corner. He can have that time to himself to heal, and I get hit. I do like my whips. It offers a good amount of gold, too, making this choice much harder. What is this? I hit myself with a freaking bomb. Of course I did. God dang it, I hate this place. There weren't even any enemies here, except for myself, of course. Thank you. straight to healing. Which one do we go for after this? I don't think relics would be a good idea. We should go for the attributes. We get relics after. Yeah, this was the better path to take. Unless I bomb myself some more. The biggest threat is this guy. This is no good. Ooh, I can't wait to have all five stamina charges back. That's a whole lot of gold. I almost hurt myself again. Some reason he's not on fire anymore. Ooh, almost messed that up. Answers that. Too early. god. This actually isn't even that bad of an idea, but, you know, the constitution would increase the healing I get. Along for that corruption. That up. You know, while I was running with the bombs the other day, after I had finished recording, I had managed to set up a build where I healed for about 400 and something damage from killing enemies with the environment. Still lost to the boss, but too early. I still lost to the final boss of this temple, but it was so much fun. I could mess up as much as I wanted, and then I could heal pretty much all of that damage back by simply hitting someone with a trap, well, killing a couple of enemies with traps. The baby and the archer are going to be the biggest issues. Okay. I don't need treasure find. Constitution. I'm not looking for anything specific from relics, from the relic. Anyway, I'm not looking for anything specific, but I'm just hoping for something good. It's not really a useful boost. Oh. I'll take the full heal so I can stop worrying about needing that. Terrible place. That's right, they don't like it from behind. This would have been useful earlier. Now we're pretty much at the final boss. It's not going to do anything for us. Sucks how difficult that was. Probably should go with attributes, right? Harder than it should be. I need to bait it in order to keep it from running. Know how much that cost. I just did it.
The greatest lesson pain teaches is that anything can be lost at any given moment. Light, hope, and life itself. Taking damage triggers a wave of darkness, and fire source in a large zone. Deal +10% damage and a light.
That's bad. That's really bad.
Thank you.
Okay, we meet again. And it starts off the same. I think I understand the guy's pattern now. That's it. I need you over here. God dang, I thought I could parry it. Good news is we've got his pattern down. All that comes next is putting all of that knowledge to use. And so ends another run. Bloody and defeated, but not beaten. Not by a long shot. What is this? Poison whip. I mean, might counter his healing somewhat. And that those chromatic knives are guaranteed elemental damage. Yeah. So, I hope you guys have enjoyed yourselves and everything you've seen here. Know that we are close to beating this temple's final boss. Well, the electric temple's final boss. Thunder temple? Lightning temple? And it would be lightning, right? Lightning temple. Anyway. We're close. So close, I can taste it. And so with all that said, we will see you next time.